Do you know what my biggest nightmare is? It's this.
Beck, where's the coffee?
We're out of coffee.
What do you mean we're out of coffee?
Didn't you see the news? There's gonna be coffee rationing all this year.
You mean there's no more coffee?
Imagine if the world ran out of coffee. This is what would happen. I couldn't function. New York City couldn't function. The US couldn't function. My coffee and yours is at risk. And you should be very, very afraid. You see, by 2050, the world's population is expected to hit 9 billion people. 9 billion, that's a heck of a lot of people. Today we can't even successfully get food and coffee to the 7 billion people who we have now. Almost a billion people go hungry every day. So now we need to fit 9 billion people on the planet, plus space for us to grow all the food for those 9 billion people, plus, you know, there's climate change about to make our weather patterns even more crazy. We in the US think that our food is pretty secure. Like, we go to Key Foods, the food is there, it's pretty cheap, and we buy it easy. But did you know that 100% of the coffee that we drink in the US was grown overseas? Except for Hawaii, the entire United States sits outside of the coffee growing region called the Coffee Belt. And so what matters to agriculture overseas really matters to the food and the coffee that we get here in the US. The only way we're gonna have a secure coffee supply is through international cooperation. So like, imagine a coffee farmer in Kenya named Thomas. Thomas wants his coffee plantation to be rich and fruitful so he can supply delicious coffee to the good people in New York City, like Beck and I. We love coffee. Coffee is what brings PsyQ to you guys. Anyway, so Thomas, the Kenyan farmer, needs to know information about when to plant, what the rainfall is going to be, and what the best seeds are that are available, how much phosphorus is left in the soil, or how hot next year's summer is going to be, how the supply routes out of Kenya are going, and what the market prices are. That's a lot of data for the average coffee farmer to collect all by himself. The only way that Thomas can be successful is by sharing information. There's research going on all the time, data being gathered from satellites, from fields, and from villagers. But most of the information that Thomas needs is protected. The researchers or the governments who pay for the research don't like to share it. So even though all the information is available, it's not available to the people who need it. Okay, so the obvious choice is to just share the information so Jayde can get her coffee. The awesome news is that there's a bunch of science, computer, and agricultural experts who want to do exactly that. They're called GODAN, or the Global Open Data for Agriculture and Nutrition. And they believe that we can solve my coffee supply and other, I guess, more important problems like world hunger by making data which is currently unavailable available, which means that Thomas can get the information that he needs to get me my coffee. Data-based innovation won't just ensure the security of my personal coffee supply. It also means cheaper and more accessible insurance for small farmers. Market data coming to farmers in their local language so they can understand price structure. Phone apps that bring them accurate weather forecasts and extreme weather warnings. So why doesn't everyone want to share their data? Well, money. Research is expensive. And why would you want to give it away for free? Second, national security. If you control the most fertile land and the information on where the water supply is, you can control the power. And so that data is often top secret. Third, access. Some farmers just don't know how to put their information online. Language is another problem. Can you imagine a coffee buyer in the US having the resources to read the supply information written in Sudanese? No. So what can PsyQ viewers do to help solve world hunger and a potential looming caffeine crisis? Well, you don't need to donate a dollar a day. You can help farmers by helping them get the information that they need. Sign the GODAN petition and tell world leaders, including the US president, who happens to hold a big chunk of the world's best research, to help make agriculture and nutritional data available, accessible, and usable. It takes less than a minute, and the link is in the description. So go now and sign it, and let us know that you've signed it by tweeting at us. Don't forget to add the hashtag PsyQMadeMeDoThis so that we can give you a personal shout out for helping secure my caffeine supply. Thanks, guys.
Hi everyone, I'm Jayde Lovell, resident science nerd on the Young Turks Network. You're watching PsyQ and we know you don't want to miss an episode, so please click the subscribe button down below.